Good morning, students. Good morning, all the viewers. It's my pleasure to welcome you all to the webinar series of Telangana State Model Schools. Today, we are going to learn matrices in our mathematics webinar series session. And we are going to learn matrices. And to continue, and from past few classes, we are learning matrices, and Madam has shared you with all the numericals, different kinds and types of numericals and practice problems also. To continue matrices, we have with us Mrs. E. Purnima, who is familiar to you all and handled several sessions in mathematics in these webinars. So good morning and welcome, ma'am. I request you to start your session, please.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Manjuri ma'am, and my coordinator Sridevi madam, and the whole webinar team. And good morning, my dear children. A very happy morning, children. I hope everyone is doing good, well and good. So let us, without any delay, let us start our math session today. Be ready with your book and pen, because from now onwards, the most important topic is going to start in matrices, children. From where you are supposed to get the essay, means the 7 marks questions you are supposed to get. So that we are going to deal in today's session, children. So before that, once again, recollect what the topics we have learnt in the last session. Okay, so let us start with the recollection part, children. So we have learnt in the last session about singular matrix. So what is a singular matrix? A singular matrix is nothing but if determinant of any matrix is equal to zero, then we say that the matrix is a singular matrix. Clear? Next, what is a non-singular matrix? What is a non-singular matrix? If determinant A is not equal to 0, then A is a non-singular matrix. Okay. So if determinant is equal to 0, then it is a singular matrix. If determinant is not equal to 0, then it is a non-singular matrix. Clear? Next. Next, what we have seen, adjoint of a matrix. Adjoint is nothing but the transpose of the cofactor matrix. So when you are finding the cofactors of every element of a matrix and we are replacing the elements with their corresponding cofactors, that forms a cofactor matrix, isn't it? So if you find the transpose of that cofactor matrix, then that is called as an adjoint of the matrix. That matrix is called as adjoint of the matrix. And next, what is that one? Next one is invertible matrix. What is invertible matrix? It is nothing but if A into adjoint A by det A is equal to adjoint A by det A into A is equal to I. Means if product of any two matrices is equal to I. See here, adjoint A by det A is again a matrix, isn't it? So if you multiply any two matrices, that product is giving you an identity matrix. Then we say that one matrix is a inverse of the other matrix. Is it clear? But what is the condition for invertible matrix? Means what is the condition that a matrix has an inverse? Means determinant A is not equal to 0. Always it is must that the A should be a non-singular matrix. When you say A as a non-singular matrix, if determinant A is not equal to 0. Clear? Then only a matrix has inverse. Understood, children? Next. Now here the A inverse is given by what? Adjoint A by det A. Next. Now in today's class, what are the important points you are going to learn in today's session? Let us see. One by one. Okay. Now, first one is we are going to see the matrix form of system of simultaneous linear equations. Means when simultaneous linear equations are given, how to represent that them in the matrix form. Okay. Next one is submatrix. What do you mean by a submatrix? And what is the rank of a matrix? And what are the consistent and inconsistent equations? And how to solve the equations we are going to see in today's session, children. Now, one after the other, we'll see. Okay, so first let us see in the first part, we are going to see what is the system of simultaneous linear equations. So in your lower classes, you learned about linear equations, isn't it? So what you learned there, we have learned about linear equations in two variables. Yes, so what are the equations we got there? A1x plus B1y is equal to some C1, A2x plus B2y is equal to C2. So those are the two linear equations we learned with two variables in your lower classes. So here also we use them. If you write them in the matrix form, they will give you the 2x2 matrix. But now we are going to see the linear equations with the three variables. So how are they? Let us see. A1x plus B1y plus C1z. There is another variable z. is equal to d1. Next one is a2x plus b2y plus c2z is equal to d2. Next, a3x plus b3y plus c3z is equal to d3. So these are the three equations, children. These are the three simultaneous equations with three variables. What are the three variables here? X, Y, and Z. Understood? So how to represent them in the form of matrix? How to represent the equations, the simultaneous linear equations in the form of a matrix? Let us see them one by one. Okay. So these are what? They are simultaneous non-homogeneous linear equations. So what do you mean by non-homogeneous? Non-homogeneous is nothing but the equations which has constants in them. Equations which has non-zero constants. The equations which has non-zero constants. They are called as what? Non-homogeneous linear equations. Understood? Means here, where are the constants, children? These three are the terms. First term, second term, third term. These three terms are having variables. X, Y, and Z. But whereas this d1, d2, d3, they doesn't have any variables. That means what? They are nothing but our constants. So these constants should be non-zero. These constants should be non-zero. They can be either negative, they can be positive. But they should be non-zero. They should not be zero. Understood, children? So then they are called as what? Non-homogeneous linear equations. Is it clear? So, if such kind of equations are there, how to represent them in the form of a matrix? So, now here, if you observe the coefficients of the variables in the first three equations, a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c3, isn't it? So, now here, these are the equations we have. Now, if you write them in the matrix form, what do we get? The matrix equations is given by ax is equals to d. So, that means a into x is equal to d. Then what is a, what is x, and what is d? Let us see what are they. A is nothing but a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c3. Okay, called as what? Coefficient matrix. So it is called, means if you write the coefficients of the three variables as a matrix, in three equations as a matrix, then that matrix is called as what? Coefficient matrix, and it is represented by a. Understood? Next, x is equal to x, y, z. What are the three variables we have in three equations? X, y, z. Okay. If these three x, y, z are the variables, if you write them in the form of a matrix, it is called as a variable matrix. It is called as the variable matrix. Next, third one is d. What is d? D1, d2, d3 are called as what? They are nothing but our constants in the equations. So if you write those constants as an as a matrix, then that is called as what? Constant matrix. It is called as a constant matrix. So if you write them as ax is equals to d, as we have seen just now, a into x is equals to d. Okay, that will give you nothing but our equation only. So once you see here, once I am moving back, children, here, if you see here, a into x is equals to d, I am telling. Okay, means what is the order of this matrix? 3 by 3. Yes, what is the order of this matrix? 3 by 1. Isn't it? So 3 by 3, 3 by 1. Okay. Now here, one more thing I will explain. After this, I will explain. Coefficient matrix augmented with the constant matrix is called augmented matrix denoted by AD. So what is it, augmented matrix? The coefficient matrix augmented with constant matrix, we are saying. Means coefficient matrix has only the coefficients and constant matrix has only constants. So if you write these two matrices together, augmented means the two matrices are written together. So then the resultant matrix is called as what? Augmented matrix. And it is denoted by AD. It is not A into D, children. It should be just read as AD. Okay. So how it looks like? Let us see. AD is equal to A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. For up to this part, it is a matrix A. This D1, D2, D3 is the matrix D. So these two matrices I am writing in a single matrix as A1, B1, C1, D1, A2, B2, C2, D2, A3, B3, C3, D3. Understood, children? Now it is nothing but our augmented matrix. Is it clear? Now one point I told, I'll explain now. So let us see what is it. So what is the matrix A, children? Here I'll explain. Here I'll explain, children, once. So A is of order. One second, I change the ink. Now, A is of order. A is of order 3 by 3. Yes. And D is of, sorry, not D. X is of order. X is of order 3 by 1. Yes, it's a column matrix. Only one column is there. So 3 by 1. So when multiplication is done, these two should be checked, isn't it? So that means what is the resultant matrix? We are saying what is our equation? We are talking about A into X is equals to D, that we are talking about. Okay. So when you do this one, when this the row columns in the first matrix A is same as rows in the second matrix X. So these two are same. Yes. So the matrix multiplication is possible. Then what is the product matrix order? Order is of 3 by 1. D. So the product matrix A into X, when you do, the product will be of order 3 by 1. So that is 3 rows and 1 column. So then what is the order of D, children? What you have taken? D is also of order 3 by 1 only, no? Yes. So that means for when you multiply this A and X, that will give you that will give you what? The constants D. Means the equations will get it. Let us see once. A1, B1, C1. Okay. Now, next what you are writing here, X, Y, Z is equal to D, we are saying. That is D1, D2, D3. Okay. Now, it is A2, B2, C2 is there here. And here also, that is this I'll explain here. A3, B3, C3. This also I'll extend here. Now, if you multiply these two children, just observe how you do usually, how is the multiplication done? First row, first column. Here only one column is there. So every row must be multiplied with this column. So A1 into X plus B1 into Y plus C1 into Z. That is equal to what? D1. A2 into X, which is nothing but our first equation. A2X plus B2Y plus C2Z is equal to D2. A3X plus B3Y plus C3Z is equal to D3. Yes, does it satisfy our equations? Yes, so that's why we are writing the coefficient matrix and variable matrix as a column matrix. And what is that? Constant matrix is also written as a column matrix only. Understood why you are writing like that? Yes. So, and what is augmented matrix? When the column coefficient matrix and constant matrix are written together, that is called as an augmented matrix and it is denoted by AD. Okay. It should be written like this only. Now here, what is a submatrix? The one more important point is, topic is submatrix. So what is the meaning of submatrix? The submatrix is nothing but, it's a, by name itself we can say, it is nothing but part of a matrix. Yes. So what is that part? Which part is called a submatrix? Let us see here. A matrix obtained by deleting some rows or columns or both of a matrix is called a submatrix of the given matrix. So what is the meaning here, children? When any matrix is given to you, if you delete some rows or columns or both, sometimes both, okay, then the matrix obtained after deleting the rows and columns is called as what? Submatrix of the given matrix. Understood, children? Submatrix of the given matrix. So what is it? Let us see. Suppose A is equal to 1, minus 2, 3, 0, minus 1, 4, minus 2, 2, 1. If it is a matrix, clear? Then here I'm writing some submatrix. What is the order of this matrix? 3 by 3. So when you are telling that some rows and some columns are deleted, so then definitely the resultant matrix what we get is not a 3 by 3. Yes or not? Because if 3 by 3 matrix we should get means what? Nothing is deleted. Understood. So if you are deleting some rows or columns, that means what? Definitely the resultant matrix will be of order less than 3 by 3 only. Yes. So now let us see here. One matrix I am writing. Then the submatrices of A are, how many submatrices we can write? 1, minus 2, minus 2, 2. What is the matrix I have written here? 1, minus 2, minus 2, 2. These four elements I have taken. Means which row and which column I have deleted here, children? I have deleted second row and third column. So I have deleted the second row and third column. Understood? So if I delete that, just I'll round it up, children. Later again I'll erase it for your understanding. I'm just rounding up this. So I'm deleting second row and third column. I have deleted second row and third column. So if I delete them, what I got? See, it is not must that only second row and third column, children. It is up to you. It is up to you. You can delete any row or any column, or a single row we can delete, or two rows we can delete. If you delete two rows, suppose, instead of deleting a column, if I delete two rows, then what will be left, children? 1, minus 2, 3. That is also a submatrix. Understood? That is also a submatrix. So that means what? By deleting some rows and columns, a single row we can delete, a single column we can delete, or together we can delete a row and a column we can delete, only two rows we can delete, only two columns we can delete. So it is up to you, children. Understood? So it is not that only this should be deleted, but only after deleting what are the elements left that form a matrix. Yes? So that matrix is called as what? Submatrix of the given matrix, original matrix. Clear? Now, once again, I'll write here. This is our matrix. So what is a submatrix? 0, minus 1, 4, minus 2, 2, 1 I have written. So by deleting what we got this one? By deleting first row. This is obtained by deleting first row. Okay. Next. One more submatrix I am writing here. Minus 2, minus 1, 2. So which column it is, children? By deleting which columns? Because it is a column we got. So by deleting which one? First column and third column. By deleting first column and third column we have got. So like this, anything we can delete, children, the matrices which are obtained, they are called as what? Submatrices. Nothing but part of the original matrix. Is it clear? So now here, we are trying to find out rank of a matrix. One thing remember, children, submatrices need not be square. They can be rectangle also, as we have seen in the examples. Is it clear? Now, rank of a matrix, I'm trying to find out. How to find out what is the meaning of rank? And how to find it? Let us see. Let A be a non-zero matrix. Let A be a non-zero matrix. Let A be a non-zero matrix. Is it clear? Now, what is this here? The rank of A is defined as the maximum of the orders of the non-singular square submatrices of A. It is denoted by rank of A. So what does it mean, children? It's very simple, children. If any matrix is there, a non-zero matrix, we are talking about a non-zero matrix. Okay. The rank of A is defined as the maximum of the orders. The maximum of the orders of the non-singular. Maximum of the orders of the non-singular square submatrices. Means if you are taking the submatrices, if you are taking the submatrices, or if you are taking a matrix itself. Okay, a matrix itself you are taking. See, in 10th class, children, one point I want to tell you. In 10th class, you learnt about sets. Yes? So, in the sets chapter, what you have learnt about subsets you learnt. So, a set itself is a subset or not? So, a set is a subset to itself. Yes or not? When you are writing subsets, we'll write the set itself also. Yes? So, similarly, here also, when you are writing submatrices, the matrix itself is a submatrix. Understood? So it will be of the same order of the original matrix. So if you are taking a matrix itself as a submatrix, then the submatrix order will be 3x3. If you are taking, if you are deleting some rows and some columns, then that will be, those submatrices order will be less than the original matrix. Understood? So how to find out the rank of the matrix? It is nothing but the maximum of the orders of the non-singular submatrices, non-singular square submatrices. Always here remember, children, whenever you are finding the rank of a matrix, the submatrices, whatever you are taking, they must be square submatrices. As just now I said, submatrices need not be square. They can be rectangular submatrices also. But whenever you are trying to find out the rank of the given matrix, the submatrices you should take should be always a square submatrices. Understood? Clear, children? So now here, and after taking the submatrices, they must be non-singular. They must be non-singular. So what, in which order? Since you are taking it, suppose a 3x3 matrix is our original matrix. If you are taking a submatrix of 2x2. So if the 2x2 matrix is, means many 2x2 matrices we can form. Yes. So from there 2x2 matrices, if we are getting a non-singular matrix, then that is the maximum order. Understood? Suppose here if all non-singular matrices are giving you as a singular matrix, means determinant 0 we are getting, then what happens? Again we have to take the another submatrix which are 1x1, because already we have checked for 3x3, which is a singular matrix. Again we are checking for the non-singular matrix of order 2x2. There also suppose you are getting our determinant as 0, then we'll check for 1 by 1 matrix. Okay, if there you are getting determinant as not equal to 0, so according to that, that will be the maximum order. That means order will be 1. Understood, children? Maximum order will be there 1. So like that, you have to check. Once you see with an example, then it will be more clear to you. Suppose if A is a non-zero matrix of order 3, then the rank of A is, how to define the rank? Let us see. If A is a non-zero matrix of order 3, means a 3 by 3 matrix we are telling, the rank of A is 3. If A is non-singular, means if the given matrix A, if you find the determinant, if the given matrix, the determinant of a given matrix A is not equal to 0, that means then if it is a non-singular matrix, then the rank is directly taken as 3. Why? Because as I said you, the matrix itself is a submatrix. Yes. So then what is the order? If it is a non-singular matrix, then what is the order, highest order? 3 by 3 matrix you are getting as a determinant not equal to 0. Yes. So that itself is the highest order. So the determinant, the rank will be how much now? Its order itself is considered as the rank. What is the order of the matrix? Of non-singular matrix you are getting 3. Order of that matrix is 3. So the rank is considered as 3. Understood? Suppose here, if A is singular, means if you are getting the determinant of A as 0, then we'll go for the submatrices of order lesser than this 3. Means a 2 by 2 submatrices we are taking. 2 by 2 submatrices we are taking. So then what happens among all the 2 by 2 submatrices, if at least one 2 by 2 submatrices is non-singular. Understood? If at least one 2 by 2 submatrix is non-singular, then that is the maximum order. Maximum of the order. That means what? Which order submatrix is giving you determinant A not equal to 0 of order 2 by 2. Yes? So that's why it is called as what? Rank is considered to be 2. Is it clear? Next, what is the third point here? Rank is considered as 1. If every 2 by 2 matrix is singular, if every 2 by 2 matrix is singular, that means how many submatrices you can form of order 2 by 2. Every 2 by 2 submatrix we check. If every submatrix is giving you the determinant as 0 only, then in such case what we do? We'll go for the next submatrix of order 1 by lesser than this 2 by 2. Understood? So what will be the order less than 2 by 2? We'll go for 1 by 1 matrix, means a single element. 1 by 1 matrix is of what? It is having a matrix having only one element in that, one row, one column. Okay, so that is a 1 by 1 matrix we'll see here. Definitely that has a non-zero element, that will have a non-zero element, because we are taking the matrix as a non-zero matrix. Definitely some non-zero elements will be there in that, no? So definitely when you are taking a 1 by 1 matrix, at least one element will be a non-zero element. So that will then the rank of that matrix is considered as 1. Understood? So first, once again, I'll check. Whenever the matrix is given as A of order 3 by 3, first we'll find the determinant of that. If that is a non-singular matrix, then directly we write rank of that matrix A is 3. Suppose if A is a singular matrix, that is determinant A is equal to 0, then we'll take the submatrices of order 2 by 2. So we'll check for this. At least one submatrix should be non-singular. So if all submatrices are singular, then again we'll go for the 1 by 1 submatrix. Okay, then if 1 by 1 submatrix means what? If it is a definitely one non-zero element will be there, then the rank is considered to be 1. Understood, children? So let us see with an example here. Suppose I'm taking a matrix here. A is equal to 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. All same elements I'm taking. Then find the rank of A. So what I'm trying to do here, first I'm trying to find out the determinant of A. 1 into its cofactor. What is that? It's because of what is the sign of this, children? Already we discussed about the minus 1 whole to the power of I plus j. What will be the sign of the first element? Plus. What will be the sign of the second element? Minus. What will be the sign of the third element? Plus. Because its position is first row, first column. So minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 1 is plus 1. It is first row, second column. So that is minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 2. That is minus 1 to the power of 3, which is minus 1. Yes, that's why its sign is minus. And here it is first row, third column. 1 plus 3 is 4. Minus 1 to the power of 4 is 1 only. So that's why it is plus sign. Okay, children. So now here we are trying to find out the determinant. 1 into its minor. What is that? 1 minus 1. Minus 1 into minus this 1 into 1 minus this row, this column is eliminated, 1, 1, 1, 1. So 1 minus 1 plus 1 into 1 minus 1. So all the elements, what will give you? All the elements will give you what? It is nothing but 0. Because 1 minus 1 is 0, 1 minus 1 is 0, 1 minus 1 is 0. Yes? So 0 plus 0 plus 0 is nothing but 0 only. That means we have got here A is a singular matrix. When A is a singular matrix, what do we know? Rank of A is not equal to 3. When you say rank is 3, if A is a non-singular matrix, then directly we can write here as rank as 3. But here it is a singular matrix. We are writing it as not equal to 3. Next one is let us go for the 2 by 2 submatrices. So any two by two submatrices you take, because all the elements are same here, definitely we are getting as 1, 1, 1, 1 only we'll get. Yes? So this is nothing but again the determinant when you try to find out, the determinant is again 0 only. Yes? AD minus BC concept. So that means similarly, any submatrix you take, that the determinant will be 0 only. So similarly, determinant of every submatrix is 0. So this implies we say that rank of A is equal to 1. That because here we go for the, because our every 2 by 2 submatrix is singular, we'll go for the 1 by 1 submatrix. So 1 by 1 submatrix is nothing but a single element we'll take. So every element is a non-zero only. Now that will give you, the determinant will be what? Not equal to 0. So that is because the determinant is itself singular matrix, 1 by 1 singular matrix. So now 1 by 1 matrix, the determinant will be itself. So that is nothing but your rank of A is equal to how much children? It is equal to 1. Understood? So like this, we have to find out the rank of any given matrix. Now, let us find the rank of this matrix, children. A matrix is given here. Expanding, I'm trying to expand along R1. Row 1, I'm trying to expand. Okay. First, row 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2. Okay. So is equal to what? 1 into 6 minus 4 minus 2 into this row, this column is eliminated, 4 minus 0 plus 3 into this row, this column is eliminated, 2 minus 0. Okay. So this is 2 minus 8 plus 6, which is equal to how much children? 6 plus 2 is 8, 8 minus 8 is 0. So A is a singular matrix. Okay. So this implies rank of A is not equal to 3. Clear? Now next what you'll see here, we'll go for the submatrices. At least one submatrix should be non-singular. So here, if you observe here, any submatrix we can take, anything, but it should be a square submatrix. 1, 2, 2, 3 I am taking. First 4 elements I am taking. It is, means how did you get this? By deleting third row and third column. Now I have got this submatrix. What will be the determinant here? 1, 3, 1 into 3 minus 2 into 2. Which is nothing but 3 minus 4, which is minus 1, which is not equal to 0. So that means what? This submatrix is non-singular submatrix, isn't it? So at least one non-singular submatrix should be there. Then we say that rank is nothing but 2. Yes? So now here it is a non-singular submatrix of A. So therefore, rank of A is equal to how much? 2. Understood, children? So like this, we have to see. Now, let us talk about another point. Consistent and inconsistent equations. So what are consistent and inconsistent equations, children? Very simple one. The system of linear equations. Just now we have seen. What is the system of linear equations? Yes. So a1x plus b1y plus c1z is equal to d1 and so on. So they are said to be consistent if it has a solution. If it has a solution. That means what? In 10th class also learned, children. What is that? With the two variables, linear equations with two variables has unique solution, or they may have infinite solutions, or they may have no solution. Yes, three different means categories we have. So if they have solution means what? They may have a unique solution, or they may have infinite solutions. Understood? So if whatever is that they are having solution or not, if they have solution, it may be unique or it may be infinite. So then they are said to be, the system is said to be consistent. The linear equations are said to be consistent linear equations. And the second one is inconsistent. If it has no solution, if the system of equations has no solution, then they are said to be inconsistent equations. Understood, children? So then how do we know? Okay, how do we know whether the system is consistent or inconsistent? Means whether it has a solution or not. If it has solution, then unique solution or infinite solution. Whether it has a unique or infinite solutions, how do we know? So we are using the concept of rank. We are using the concept of rank to find out this consistency and inconsistency of the equations. Clear, children? So what is that? Let us see. So these are the coefficient matrix and augmented matrix we know. Yes, these two things already we have discussed just now. Okay. Now, the system of three equations, Ax is equals to D, A into X is equals to D. Okay. The, what is this also explained to you. So then has, first one, a unique solution if rank of A is equal to rank of AD is equal to 3. So when the system has a unique solution, children, if rank of A is equal to rank of AD, means A is nothing but a coefficient matrix, AD is nothing but augmented matrix. So if you are trying to find out the ranks of these two, then if two ranks are equal and as well as they must be equal to 3. Understood? So when you get 3, children, if the matrix itself is a non-singular matrix, if the matrix itself is a non-singular matrix, then only we get the rank as 3. Isn't it? So if the two ranks are equal and if that is equal to 3, then only we say that the matrix, the system of equations has unique solution. Next, infinitely many solutions. If rank of A is equal to rank of AD, but it should be less than 3. Less than 3 means it can be 2 or it can be 1. But means rank can be 2 or rank can be 1. Only the thing is rank of A must be same as rank of AD. In these two cases, we say that it is having unique solution, it is having infinite solutions. So in these two cases, we say that the system of equations are consistent. Yes. So that means when do we have the consistent equations, children? When rank of A is equal to rank of AD. Understood. So in these two cases, the two ranks must be equal only. But if it is equal to 3, then we have unique solution. If it is less than 3, then we have infinite solutions. Okay. And the next one is no solution if rank of A is not equal to rank of AD. Means if rank of the coefficient matrix is not equal to rank of augmented matrix AD. So then now we say that the system has no solution. Understood. So now you know how to find out the rank of A. Yes, but how to find out the rank of AD? Because as I said, when you are finding the rank, that must be a square matrix. But if you observe here, augmented matrix is not a square matrix, isn't it? So it is what here? This is a 3 rows and 4 columns are there, 3x4 matrix. So it is not a square matrix. Then how can you find out the rank? So let us see how to do it. Let us see, children. So here, how to find out the rank? Let us discuss here in using a sum. So what is the question here? X plus y plus z is equal to 4, and 2x plus 5y minus 2z is equal to 3, and x plus 7y minus 7z is equal to 5. Okay, using rank method. So let us see how can you do it. Okay, children. So first of all, let us write the given equations in the matrix form. And as a coefficient matrix and an augmented matrix. Okay. A is equal to 1, 1, 1, 2, 5, minus 2, 1, 1, 7, minus 7. Okay. So this is what? It's a coefficient matrix A. And next what you should write? Augmented matrix AD. Augmented matrix AD we did. So let us write it, children. 1, 1, 1 constant. What is the constant here? 4. Next, 2, 5, minus 2, 3. Okay. Third one is 1, 7, minus 7, and 5. Okay. So now this is your augmented matrix. Now, here we are trying to find out the rank. Using rank method, you are trying to find out the solutions. So, first you should know whether it has a unique solution or infinite solutions or no solutions. Then only we can find out those solutions. Understood, children? So for that, what I am trying to do is first we'll try to find out determinant of augmented matrix. Determinant of augmented matrix AD. Understood? So one second, children. Okay. So augmented matrix, children. So now here, what is that? Let me write them in the form of determinant. 1, 1, 1, 4, okay, 2, 5, minus 2, 3, 1, 7, minus 7, and 5, okay. Now, it is your augmented matrix. Now, to find this one augmented order, determinant of this augmented matrix, first we are trying to means first what I am trying to do is I am trying to apply some row transformations, children, so that to make the elements as zeros. So always remember, children, whenever you are using the rank method, you have to make this matrix. See, in this augmented matrix part, we are finding this coefficient matrix A, 1, 1, 1, 2, 5, minus 2, 1, 7, minus 7. So this is the what, up to this part, it is nothing but our matrix A. Yes? So this matrix A should be converted to an upper triangular matrix. Or to what you should convert, children, I'll write here, upper triangular matrix. Upper triangular matrix. So what is upper triangular matrix? Means this is a diagonal. I'm talking about only the matrix A, children. So this matrix 1, 5, minus 7 are the elements of the diagonal. So below that diagonal, what are the three elements we have? 2, 1, 7. So these three elements should be made as 0. They should be converted as 0. So that point you remember, children. Understood? So if any matrix is there like this, just so for your understanding, I'm writing here. It is a diagonal. Before the diagonal, the elements, three elements will have. These three elements should be made as zeros. So this part you remember. So using some transformations, we do that. So based on the transformations, these elements, the remaining elements are also changing. Understood? Remaining elements also change, but you don't worry about them. You are only concerned with these three elements only. They must be made as zeros. That you remember. Okay. So what can you do here? Let us see. So first, let us try to make this element zero and this element zero. Okay. Now what I am trying to do is, here 2 is there. How can you make this 2 as 0? 2 minus 2 we can do. Okay. So now always when you are trying to do that, always make use of the above row. Understood? So 2 minus, how can you get 2 here? If you multiply this 1 with 2, we'll get as 2. So I'm making a change in the R2. R2 tends to R2 minus 2R1 I'm doing. Understood, children? Similarly, I'm making a change in R3 also. R3 tends to R3 minus R1 I'm doing. So then what happens here? It becomes first row, I'm not making any change. 1, 1, 1, 4. Okay. Second row, R2 minus 2R1 I are telling. 2 minus 2 1s are 2. 2 minus 2 is 0. 5 minus 2 1s are 2. 5 minus 2 is 3. Okay. Here minus 2 is there. Minus 2 minus 2 into 1. Minus 2 minus 2 is how much? Minus 4. Minus 2 minus 2 is how much? Minus 4. Next. Here 3 is there. 3 minus 2 into 4 is 8. 3 minus 8 is minus 5. Okay. Next. Third row. R3 minus R1. 1 minus 1 is 0. 7 minus 1 is 6. Minus 7 minus 1 is minus 8. 5 minus 4 is 1. Clear? So like this, we have to make the elements. Let me write the matrix again, children. Sorry, it's not a matrix, it is a determinant. Now in the next page also, let me write the matrix, the determinant again. 1, 1, 1, 4, 0, 3, minus 4, minus 5, 0, 6, minus 8, 1. Okay, so let us write that. Determinant of AD is equal to, let me write the elements, children. 1, 1, 1, 4, okay, 0, 3, minus 4, minus 5, next, 0, 6, minus 8, 1. So these are the elements what we got. Now next, what is the next thing here? These two zeros we got. Now this is your diagonal element. So this element is also should be made as 0. How can you make this 6 as 0? Yes, how can you make this 6 as 0? 6 minus 6 we should do. So as we did, like similar to R3, I'm making a change in R3, children. See, always whenever you are making a change for this element, because this should be made as 0, already we made these two as zeros. So these two should not get changed, children. That point keep it in mind. Suppose here, just an example I'm explaining here, children. R3 minus 6R1 if you do, for suppose, it is not correct thing, but I am explaining why you should not do like that. R3 minus 6R1, for suppose if you do, then what happens, children? I mean, if I try to change the matrix here, what happens? 1, 1, 1, 4. R3 minus 6R1 if you do, 0 minus 6 into 1 is what? 6. 0 minus 6 is minus 6. So this element is getting changed, but you are not supposed to change this element because it should be 0 only here. Yes, so that's why here what you should do is to not make use of R1 here. Understood? Understood, children? Only to explain, you should not do, why you should not do like that. I have explained like this. Because if you make use of R1 here, what happens? The elements which you made into 0, those will be changed. So that's why here you should not make that. Now, R3 tends to, what you should do here? R3 minus 2R2 I am doing. Why I am doing 2R2? Because here we have 3. If you multiply this 3 with 2, what happens? 3 to the 6. 6 minus 6 becomes 0. So, but even if here it doesn't make any change, because R3 minus 0 into 2 is also 0 only. So 0 minus 0 will become 0 only. So these two elements are not changing anyway. So that's that part you should keep in mind. Now, this is here. One second, children. Let me go to the previous here also. The similar symbol. Here, what are the changes? 1, 1, 1, 4, 0, 3, minus 4, minus 5. Okay. Now here, R3 minus 2, R2. 0 minus 0 is 0 only. 6 minus, here 3, 2 is 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. Minus 8, minus 2 into minus 4. So minus into minus is plus. Minus 8, 2 into 4 is 8. Minus 8 plus 8 becomes 0. Here it is 1. Minus into minus is plus. 2, 5 is 10. 1 plus 10 is 11. Understood? So this is the augmented matrix we have got. Understood, children? This is the augmented matrix we have got. Now we are trying to find out. Now we are trying to find out the rank of the matrix A and matrix augmented matrix. Now here, for this part, what you are trying to do is, after getting this diagonal matrix 0, here, see, this element you have got here 0, but it is not always, won't get like this, children. Here in this sum, we have got like this. Now, up to this part, the first three columns are what part of the matrix A, no? No, no, let us take the those three rows to find the matrix A determinant. 1, 1, 1, 0, 3, minus 4, 0, 0, 0. Up to three, only first three columns only I'm taking, which is equal to, what is the determinant of a matrix which has one row or one column as 0? It is nothing but 0 only, no? As we have learned in the properties of determinants. Yes, here the R, since R3, every element R3 has, every element of R3 has 0. Since every element of R3 is 0. Every element of R3 is 0. So this implies our determinant of A is equal to 0 we got. Next is what here? Determinant of, when you are finding determinant of matrix A, we are supposed to find out rank. So determinant is, we got it as 0. That means what? Rank is not equal to, rank of A is not equal to 3. Is not equal to 3. So now we are supposed to find out the submatrices. So one submatrix we'll take. So submatrix. Submatrix. Any one submatrix we can take, children. 1, 1, 0, 3. Again, R3 and column 3 I am deleting. So what is the determinant here? 1 into 3 minus 0 into 1. Okay. Which is 3 minus 0, which is 3. So it is not equal to 0. So this implies what? The submatrix is a non-singular submatrix we have got. Rank of A is equal to how much, children, here? We got rank of A as 2. Now, next thing is we have to find out rank of AD. Okay. Now, what is the matrix AD here? The four columns are there. But here it is a rectangular matrix. As I said, when you are finding the rank, it must be a square matrix. So then here what you should do is, this is a column. The fourth column should be taken must. Understood? From these three columns, any two columns you take. Understood? But here because it is a 1, 0, 0, this usually will take, because to make the determinant part simple, we'll make this one. So in these two columns, eliminate one column, any one, it is up to you. First, second, fourth we can take, or first, third, fourth we can take, Understood. So anything we can take. Now let us try to take first, second, and fourth. 100, 136, 4 minus 5, 1. Okay. So 4 minus 1, I think it is 11 children, not 1. Okay, let us try to find the determinant of the AD. AD is equal to, determinant of AD is equal to 100. Okay, what is the second column? 130. And what is the third one here? That is the last column, 4 minus 5, 11. Understood? So these three columns, one column we can eliminate. So let us try to find out the determinant. 1 into this row and this column is eliminated. 3 into 11 minus 5 into 0. This is 0 minus 1 into, it has a plus sign, it has a minus sign, it has plus sign children. Expanding along R1. Here I'll write. I'm expanding along R1. So it is 1 into 3 into 11 minus 5 into 0. Next, minus 1 into this one is 0 minus 0 plus 4 into 0 minus 0. So it is 33. How much we got here? 33, which is not equal to 0. So because the determinant is not equal to 0, what is rank of AD now? AD matrix rank is how much? AD, rank of AD is equal to 2. Is it clear? So that means what here? What did you get here? One second. Rank of AD is equal to how much? Rank of AD is equal to how much here, children? It is nothing but rank of AD is nothing but how much here? Because it is directly the matrix AD is giving you a non-singular matrix. Rank of AD is nothing but 3. Yes. So if you get a singular matrix, then you will go for the submatrices. But here directly we have gotten determinant as not equal to 0, and rank of AD is how much we will take here? It is considered to be 3. So that means what here? When rank of AD is equal to 3, rank of A, how much we got? Rank of A, we got it as 2, and rank of AD is equal to 3. That means rank of A is not equal to rank of AD. Rank of A is not equal to rank of AD. Understood? So that means what here? The system of equations has no solution. Understood, children? The system of equations has no solution. The system of equations has no solution. Understood? So we'll find out the rank of the matrix. Is it clear? So when rank of A and rank of AD we'll find out. If it is not equal, then we'll say that the system of equations has no solution. Understood? So now let us see one more sum, children. Now I'm trying, in today's class, I'm trying to explain you the three different kinds of sums. Means where you have unique solution, where you have infinite solutions, and where you have no solution. So one sum already I explained you, children. The next sum is solve x plus y plus z is equal to 6. And x minus y plus z is equal to 2. 2x minus y plus 3z is equal to 9 using rank method. So let us first try to write them in the matrix form. Okay. Now, A is equal to, what is A? 1, 1, 1, 1 minus 1, 1, 2 minus 1, 3. Okay. AD I am trying to write here. AD is equal to 1, 1, 1, 6, 1 minus 1, 1, 2, 2 minus 1, 3, 9. Okay. Now, this is your matrix. Now, when you are trying to find out the determinant, what I said, first we have to find out the, we are trying to find out the, simplify the given matrix AD. So, I'm trying to find out the row, so I'm applying some row transformations to make it simple. Okay. So, what are the, means up to A, what is the matrix here? 1, minus 1, 3 are the diagonal elements of A. So, these three elements, 1, 2, 1, 2, minus 1, these three should be made as zeros. Okay, so what can you do here, children? What are the transformations we can do? R2 tends to R2 minus R1. Directly we can make as 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. Next, R3 tends to R3 minus 2R1. Okay, 2 minus 2 is what? 0. So if you apply those, this one. Okay, 1, first row there is no change, 1, 1, 1, 6, second row, R2 minus R1, 1 minus 1 is 0, minus 1, minus here, minus 1 is 2, minus 2, next, 1 minus 1 is again 0, next 2 minus 6 is minus 4, okay, next R3 minus 2R1 is what, 2 minus 2 is 0, it is 0 children, minus 1, minus 2. Minus 1, minus 1 into 2 is minus 2. Minus 1, minus 2 is how much? Minus 3. Minus 1, minus 2 is minus 3. One second. 1, minus 1. 2, minus 2 is 0. Okay. Minus 1, minus 2 into 1. Minus 2, minus 1, minus 2 is how much? Minus 3. Next is 3 minus 2 is what? 1. Next is 9 minus 9 minus 6 2s are 12. 9 minus 12 is minus 3. Okay. So here, sorry, I forgot here, no? 3 minus 2 is what? 1. 0 minus 3, 1 minus 3. Understood, children? So these are the elements what we got. Next, what you should make here, these two elements already we got 0. Next one is what? This element should be made as 0. How can you make here this element as 0? Already I told you, if you make use of R1, these elements will change. So that's why here always you should make use of R2 only. Understood? So that these two elements doesn't have any change in them. Understood? So what can we do here? So let me do it in the next slide, children. So let me write that matrix again here. Or else it's similar to what are the elements here? We have 1, 1, 1, 6, 0, minus 2, 0, minus 4 we got. Next is here 0 we got, here minus 3 we got, 1 and minus 3 we got. Okay. Now what are the changes we can do here? Here this element should be made as 0. So what can I do here is R3, because here this 2 doesn't have any, means directly we cannot cancel them. What can you do? We'll have to see for the common multiple. LCM we have to see. What is the common multiple? 6. How can you make this as 6? Multiply with 2. How can you make this as 6? Multiply with 3. So here it is R3 tends to 2 times of R3, 2R3 minus 3R2. 2R3 minus 3R2. Okay. So now here it becomes now 1, 1, 1, 6. 0, minus 2, 0, minus 4. There is no change in R2. R3, it is 0 only. This element will not change. Now here, minus 3 into 2 is minus 6. Minus into minus is plus. 3 2s are 6. Minus 6 plus 6 is 0. Okay, and next here. 2 1s are 2. 2 minus 3 into 0 is 0. 2 minus 0 is 2. Next here. Minus 3 2s are minus 3 into 2 is minus 6. Minus 6, minus into minus is plus, 3 4 is 12. Minus 6 plus 12 is plus 6. Okay. Now this is the element what we got. Now here, in let it be equation number 1. Why I am making it as equation number 1? We'll come to know later. So let it be equation number 1. Now let us try to find out the rank of the matrices. Determinant of A we'll find out. So what is that? 1, 1, 1. Up to element matrix A part only we are taking 0, minus 2, 0. 0, 0, 2. Okay, children? Now, expanding along C1. Expanding along column 1. So, 1 into this row, this column, minus 2 into 2, minus 0, plus minus 0 plus 0, which is equal to minus 2 into 2 is minus 4, minus 4 into 1 is minus 4. So, minus 4 I got, which is not equal to 0. So, it is a non-singular matrix I got. Understood? So, this implies what? Rank of A is how much, children, here? Rank of A is 3. Because directly I got A itself, determinant of A is not equal to 0. I can write rank of A as 3. Okay. Now, let me write this equation number 1 again here. Equation 1116, 0 minus 2, 0 minus 4, 0, 0, 2, 6. So this was our equation number 1. Okay. Now, rank of A is equal to 3 we got. Now, let us try to find out rank of AD. So, for that, we need to find out the determinant. So, as I said you, any one column we can skip. 1, minus 2, 0, 6, minus 4, 6. This last column is must children. Okay. Now, expanding along C1 again. Expanding along C1. Okay. What happens here? 1 into minus 2 into 6 minus 4, 0 into minus 4 is 0. And it is minus 0 plus 0. So which is minus 12. Minus 12 means what? How much we got rank of minus 6 into minus 12? Is not equal to 0. So this implies rank of AD is equal to 3. Understood. So now here we have got rank of A is equal to 3 and rank of AD is equal to 3. Yes. So from here, what can you say, children? What can I say here? So what can I say here, children? When so here what okay. So rank of A is equal to rank of AD we got. So that means what here, what kind of solutions it has, children? It has a unique solution. Is it clear? It has a unique solution. So let us write that. So it has, system has, system of rank of A here rank of A is equal to rank of A is equal to rank of AD. What we got? Rank of A is equal to rank of AD is equal to how much we got? It is equal to 3 we got. Both are having rank as 3 only. So from here, what can you say? This implies system of equations has unique solution. Isn't it? It is having unique solution. So then what is a solve? Your question is to solve. Because it has a unique solution, we are supposed to find out that. So what is our equation number 1? Let us write it again, children. Our equation number 1 is 1116, 0 minus 2, 0 minus 4, 0, 0, 2, 6. So this was our equation number 1. Okay. Now we are trying to find out the solution. Now let us, because this last column is meant for the constants. Yes. The first is x, second one is y, third one is z. Yes. So let us equate the, let us write them in the form of an equation. From equation number 1, x plus y plus z is equal to 6. Okay. X plus y plus z is equal to 6. Let it be equation number 2. Next, second one, x coefficient is 0. So no need to write that. Minus 2y, z is also 0 here, is equal to minus 4. From here, y is equal to how much? Minus minus is cancelled. 4 by 2 means 2. Y is equal to 2 we got. So now, and from the third one, z directly it is 2z. And 2z is equal to 6. Implies z is equal to 3. Okay, now we got y value we got and z value we got. Now we are trying to find out from equation 2. From equation 2, x plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 6. So what is x now here? 6 minus 5, which is equal to 1. So therefore, x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2, z is equal to 3. Understood, children? Like this, we have to find out. Is it clear? So first, you should find out the rank of the two matrices. If they are having a unique solution or infinite solutions or no solutions, we'll find out from there. Then from after you get a unique solution, the determinant after converting them to a lower upper triangular matrix, this matrix should be from here, the value should be written in the form of equations. So from there, by solving them, we'll get the values of variables. Understood? So let us see here. One second, children. Just hold a minute, children. So now here, what is the question, children? Solve x minus 3y. Solve x minus 3y minus 8z is equal to 10. 3x plus y minus 4z is equal to 0. 2x plus 5y plus 6z is equal to 13. Using the rank method. Okay. Now we are trying to solve this one, children. So let us see. Here it is. So here it is, solution. Let us try to write the directly. I'm writing the matrix AD here, children. Here I write AD. Okay. 1 minus 3 minus 8 minus 10. 3, 1 minus 4, 0. 2, 5, 6, it is 5, 2, 5, 6, 13. Okay. Now, this is your matrix determinant, augmented matrix AD. Now, here what I am trying to do is R2 tends to, because these three elements should be made as zeros. Yes, R2 tends to R2 minus 3R1. Similarly, R3 tends to R3 minus 2R1. Clear? So, now what we get, children, here, 1, minus 3, minus 8, minus 10, there is no change in R1, R2, 3 minus 3 is 0, 1, minus 3 into minus 3, minus into minus is plus, 3 is a 9, 1 plus 9 is 10, okay, next, minus 4, minus into minus is plus, minus 4, 8 is a 24, minus 4 plus 24 is 20, next is 0, minus into minus is plus 30, 10, 3 is a 30, next is, here, 2 minus 2 is 0, 5, minus 2 into minus 3 is plus 6, 5 plus 6 is 11. Next here, 6 minus into minus is plus 8 to the 16. 16 plus 6 is 22. Next 13 plus 30. Sorry, plus 20. 13 plus 20 is 33. Understood? So like this, we have to find the next one is what third element. This element should be made as 0. How can you make this as 0? Because here these two, let us take the common multiple. 110 is a common multiple. So R3 tends to 10 into R3, 10 into R3 minus 11 into R2, minus 11 into R2. Is it clear? So first and second row is same, children, only the change is done in the third one. So it is first row is 1 minus 3 minus 8 minus 10. Second row is 0, 10, 20 and 30. Okay. Now let us take, see the third row. It is 0. What was the 10 into R3? What was our transformation, children? 10 into R3 minus 11 into R2. Yes. 0. Here that element will become 0. And here we had 22 we had. Yes. The 22 into 10 is 210. 210 minus 11 into 20. How much? 11 to the 22. 220 minus 220 is again 0 only. And here it is. What was the element here? 33 was there. So 33 into 2 is 33 into 10 is 330 minus 11 into 30 is 330. So it is also again 0 only. Okay. Now here all the elements of the row 4, row 3 are zeros. Now let us try to find out the determinant of A. Determinant of A I am trying to find out is equal to determinant of 1 minus 3 minus 8, 0, 10, 20, 0, 0, 0. As one row is 0 here, the determinant is taken as 0. The rank is not equal to 3. Rank of A is not equal to 3. Now we'll take the submatrix, children. 1 minus 3, 0, 10. Okay. Which is equal to 1 into 10 minus 0 into minus 3, which is 10, which is not equal to 0. This implies rank of A is equal to how much here? 2. Because one submatrix is non-singular. So it is rank is considered to be 2. Now similarly, we'll find out the rank of AD. Rank of AD, okay, is equal to what? 1 minus 3, 10, minus 10, 0, 10, 30, 0, 0, 0. Here also one row is 0, so its determinant is also equal to 0. So rank of AD is not equal to 3. So again one submatrix we take here also, 1 minus 3, 0, 10. It is also same. 1 into 10 minus 0, so it is also equal to 10, which is not equal to 0. So rank of AD is how much here? Rank of AD is equal to 2, because submatrix is not equal to 0 we got. So rank of AD is equal to 2. So rank of A is equal to 2 and rank of AD is equal to 2. Both are same, but they are less than 3, isn't it? So we can write here, rank of A is equal to rank of AD. Okay, is less than 3, is equal to how much we got? 2 we got, which is nothing but less than 3. So this implies system has infinite solutions. System has infinite solutions. Understood? So then how can you find out those infinite solutions? Let us see. So it is nothing but, let me write the equation number 1 here once again, children. So to write that in the form of equations, 1 minus 3 minus 8 minus 10, 0, 10, 20, 30, 0, 0, 0, 0. This was our equation number 1. Okay. Let us write them in the form of equations. The first one is x minus 3y minus 8z is equal to minus 10. And from the second row, we can write it as 10y plus 20z is equal to 30. Third row, there is no third row, so leave it. Now it is equation number 2 and it is equation number 3. Now here, from here, we can take 10 common. So that it becomes y plus 2z is equal to 3. Okay, so they let this be equation number 3. Instead of this, let this be equation number 3. Now here, because this has infinite solutions, we need to find out them. So for this kind of sums, we need to take it as one variable as k. So let us assume some y is equal to k. Let y is equal to any variable we can take, children. So let y is equal to k. So from equation number 3. What is equation number 3? Y plus 2z is equal to 3. So that becomes now k plus 2z is equal to 3. Okay. So z is equal to now 3 minus k. Z is equal to 3 minus k by 2. Or else we'll do one thing. Instead of y, we can take it as we can take z as k. I'm taking z as k so that to avoid that fraction, you can take y as also k, nothing, no wrong in that, but only to avoid that fraction I'm considering z as k. So from equation number 3, what happens, children? Y plus 2k is equal to 3. So then what is y now? 3 minus 2k. Okay, so So now y we got, z we got from equation number 2. X minus 3 into 3 minus 2k minus 8 into z is k is equal to minus 10. So this implies x minus 9 minus into minus is plus 6k minus 8k plus 10 is equal to 0. Okay. Now this implies x is equal to how much children? X is equal to 6k minus 8k is minus 2k. Minus 2k will go other side means plus 2k. Minus 9 plus 10 is plus 1. Plus 1 goes other side means becomes minus 1. So x is equals to 2k minus 1. So therefore, what are the values we got? X is equals to 2k minus 1. Y is equal to 3 minus 2k. So therefore, we write it as x is equal to how much we got? 2k minus 1. Y is equal to 3 minus 2k. Next, z is equal to k. Then what is this k? For k belongs to R, real number. It can be k, can be anything. Understood, children? So like this, we have to find out the infinite solutions. So these are the things, children, important points, what we have discussed in today's class. So once we'll see in brief, how to write the given linear equations as a matrix form we have discussed. From where these are the equations, it is a coefficient matrix. It is a variable matrix, and D1, D2, D3 are the constant matrix, and it is an augmented matrix. When a variable coefficient matrix and a constant matrix written together, it is a augmented matrix. And the next one is what I have seen, a submatrix. Matrix obtained by deleting some rows or columns. That is a submatrix. And rank is nothing but if it is a matrix is of order 3. If it is a non-singular matrix, then rank is considered as 3. And if it is a singular matrix, then we'll go for the submatrices determinant. If at least one submatrix is non-singular, then it rank is considered to be 2. And if every submatrix is singular only, then the rank is considered to be 1. Okay. And next here, consistent and inconsistent equations. The system is consistent if it has a solution. It may be unique or it may be infinite solutions. And it is inconsistent if it has no solution. The system of equations is what AX is equals to D has a unique solution if rank of A is equal to rank of AD, which is equal to 3. Next, it has infinite solutions if rank of A is equal to rank of AD is less than 3. Next is, if it has no solution if rank of A is not equal to rank of AD. Understood, children? And based on these three different kind of solutions, we have discussed the sums. Then try to do it in your notebook, the remaining sums also. So for your practice, I'm giving you two questions, children. Solve these two questions using rank method. Understood? So hope you have understood everything. Thank you, children. Have a good day. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Purnima ma'am, for a very excellent presentation on matrices. And children, madam has given you some practice problems. Try to solve those problems and revisit the matrices entire webinar sessions again and again, so that you will get a grip over this matrices. And matrices is a very interesting chapter. And I think you are going to continue for the next session as well, no ma'am?
Yeah, ma'am.
So for when we meet in the next session, please be ready with the test your understanding problems madam has given to you. Try to solve those so that it's a real communication between your teacher and yourself. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you once again. Thank you.